Right now, we are in Simple City, Southeast Washington, D.C. Man, I had to come say what's up. Yes, sir.
How you feeling?
I'm good, I'm good. Good to see you.
Likewise.
Hello, good to see you again.
You too.
This place in particular relates to my project because most of what I'm speaking about is the perspective of somebody that I'm really good friends with that's from here.
Simple City means to me, it means home, family.
How we come, we move as one.
Trials and tribulations. We all go through them.
We have family out here. That's really all we got, you know?
The dynamic of where I'm from and the dynamic of this area is kind of what bridges the gap between the type of music that people could say I should make versus the type of music that I decided to make. G.
Got me pulling up in the legendary Simple City.
Yes. Yeah, right now.
That's what the album's called, Simple.
Yeah, it's called Simple. Exactly.
This right here, this is for go-go music.
Yeah.
I mean, this was like, this is it. This is the Mecca, right? But how did that influence you? Like, tell me your relationship with Simple City.
Well, through my friend Wax, he connected me with somebody from here, my boy Fly. And this is like probably 2016. I came around here, you know, I'm from more so the suburbs.
Right.
Not too far, like about 20 minutes away from here. So it was my first time really being around an environment like this, where it's like you hear about it, but you know, if you don't live it or you don't see it, you don't really understand it. So he brought me around here. That kind of is what influenced me to make this project Simple, because for me, you know, I love the idea of dancing and having fun to music, but I always wanted to tell a story that was real that a lot of people who normally would listen to my music wouldn't understand.
Mm.
Yeah.
This area is going through a lot of change too, right?
Like yeah.
Gentrification, like a lot of cities.
Yeah.
Obviously, this where Simple City's located in Southeast D.C.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the proximity to getting to work.
Yeah.
You got houses, brick houses, you know what I mean? Beautiful landscape, parks and things like that. You know, as black families have moved out of here, right? People are coming in and buying it up.
Yeah, exactly. And my area where I'm from is what happens after people get moved out due to gentrification. And the issue that I've seen is, like, when people move out, they end up going to these areas to create a better life for themselves, but gentrification doesn't change your mentality. It just changes the environment you're in. And I just realized really quickly that just when you change the environment, people do the same stuff. You know what I'm saying? So basically, where I'm from, you know, we got $300,000, $400,000, $600,000 houses, but people still getting shot.
Right.
Still robberies going on. You know, even with me, like, I grew up in a nice neighborhood, but I went to a really bad school. And being in a bad school and not getting good grades, who I'm gonna hang with? The other people that's not getting good grades. And that's how I kind of started to fall into the criminal path that I had, you know?
I think there's a greater story and realization of a general sickness of a society, whether you have or have not, right? Because a lot of people think, oh, I'm gonna move out of an area where, you know, let's say it's predominantly black and I'm gonna move to a better lifestyle, let's say. But that doesn't change the way the environment of the greater society deals with your children, deals with you, the police, the job availability, access to capital so you can buy and purchase and credit lines and these things that help people build wealth, right? And that's, I think, what contributes to this reoccurring cyclical feeling of I got the weight of the world on my shoulders and there's no way out. And people start to have emotional issues with that, mental health issues come out of that, abuse of different kinds, whether that be verbal, physical, substance.
Yeah, 100%. You know? Like, there's a lot of PTSD and all of that from the things that people go through as well.
That's right.
And that's why, like, the album Simple is like telling people the fix to these problems aren't simple. I kind of have an issue with certain groups of people looking at areas like this and saying, why can't you just stop doing drugs? Or why can't you just do the right thing? You guys are criminals. You guys are this, that, and the third. when they have no idea how it feels to grow up in a neighborhood like this.
When they're not even factoring the ramifications of generations of abuse on a community or a group of people put on by the government, put on by the institutions that have abused and taken advantage of people, and that PTSD, right? That becomes behavior that's handed on to generations to come.
Exactly.
But one thing about Simple City, like a lot of neighborhoods, you got people dealing with a lot. But I'm sure you know from coming around here, it's also a lot of love.
Yeah, a lot of love.
It's also a lot of people who have withstood and continue to withstand and not let the world make them feel ugly on the inside.
100%.
You know what I'm saying? DC is such an interesting place musically. And then when you listen to this album, Simple, it's not just you trying to sound like everything that's already available in hip hop. It's you trying to bring something to the conversation that makes people think about you different, think about what's possible in hip hop differently. Mm-hmm. Talk about that journey.
As I grow and do music, I realize very quickly that the things around me doing music almost matter a lot more than just the music itself. So I started to take like a different approach, you know. It was like, if I'm gonna make music, and that's fine, but how do I create something that's gonna change people's perspective and something that's gonna stick with people forever, you know? Mm. And then I just started to do other things around that for me, you know, I always look at myself as a, before I'm a rapper or producer or any of that, I'm a problem solver. That's what I'm good at. Mm. I'm good at identifying a problem and figuring out a way to solve it. And my passion is teaching. So it's like, it's almost like KRS-One. You know what I mean? Like, I love teaching in general, and I just happen to use music as that vessel. And so that's kind of a reflection of how things sound and feel.
How did you and K Trinata connect, and what was that working relationship like? How did you guys create?
I connected with K at a Jordan party, actually, in L.A., and it was basically the same mutual feeling, where it was like we both wanted to connect with each other. And that turned into a studio session, which then became, you know, the actual project. And then it took about 2 years of just starting something, coming back to it later, then deciding, all right, let's finish this up to put it out.
We are standing at the location in Simple City where you shot the taco video.
Yes, yes.
I want to talk about the titles of the songs on the album. Taco, amazing record. The one with Denzel Curry, Dog Food.
Yeah.
Another favorite. Why those titles?
Everything that I kind of put together for the most part is almost like a definition for a certain thing. Like, for instance, taco. A lot of people say taco shells when they refer to gun shells, you know, and I decided to name that song Taco because of the nature of what it's talking about. Mm-hmm. You get what I'm saying? Dog food is another specific one that's based off of, you know, the dog food being a substance that people use or sell, you know. And I've seen someone say, yo, I love the songs, but the names are horrible. They don't understand the context. But the great part about that is, for me, I always think, if I put something in my music that allows you or forces you to try to figure out what it means and why, you'll retain the memory of when you find out what it means a lot better than if I tell it to you. Right. You know what I'm saying? So I want people to put in the work and just understand why I call it taco, dog food, things like that, on a code, all of that.
Simple City means to me trials and tribs, you know, a lot of pain.
Lost a good amount of people to the system.
I feel as though without my hood, I wouldn't be the man who I am today. We just want to see each other win. And I think that's what makes Simple City, Simple City. Just the love.
Simple. What's up, brother? Respect, sir. Thanks for having us.
Yeah, ain't no question.
Yeah, man. What's up, sir? Good to meet you, man.
You too.
Introduce yourself to the people, young Balla. Where you from? And give them the whole one rundown.
Young Balla from Simple City, right here. No, Top Bop, they call me.
And you, sir?
Big Wax, D.C.
There you go. Tell us about, you know, just the significance of Simple City and what you do as kind of like a mentor to a lot of people.
You know, Simple City is a pillar in the city. It's just like a Berry Farms. It's one of those neighborhoods that the whole DMV area know. just on the name alone and the people that has come from around here, like Limbaugh's, you know, that court right there, he used to play on that court back there. So, you know, Symbol City got a lot of deep roots in history, you know, and like with J.I.D.K., I bumped into this guy, you know, he was coming home from jail, but he had a vision and he was so confident in what he was talking about. And I kind of gravitated towards that to see somebody that $0, really not having anything but what he had in him, what he believed in, you know, and the confidence that he had in himself. And that made me gravitate towards him. And then to this day, you know, I pull out the LA and I look up and he on the billboard. And I'm like, this is crazy. Like, this is the same dude had on overalls and a bandana with $50. You know what I mean? For real. Like, it's crazy. Like, the same bandana he was wearing those, but they was like black and he had an overall.
Now he got some fly material. He got some sweat.
Diamond in his ears. Come and pick me up in the Maybach and shit. And I'm like, damn. You know what I mean? Like, came along. Long way, man. You know, so anything that he doing, I'ma support. Same with Balla, man. Balla, we got family ties. You know what I mean? So this whole community, we tied into this community.
Tell me about you and why that family thing is so important, and you fight for that and fight for it in this community.
So in DC, we have a real culture within DC as a whole. But then what's so funny is that every other hood, right, have their own culture too. That's within right. That culture, right? And this is why you see a lot of times when you have two communities conflicting with each other, they had two separate cultures. And sometimes that culture might be generations ago. Mm-hmm. Those two neighborhoods would go to the basketball court and we'd go up to the swimming pool and we'd fight each other, right? Mm-hmm. But it was just fist fights. With no guns, with no knives, none of that. We just fought each other, right? Mm-hmm. And then today, that has trickled into
gunplay.
Right, the gunplay, right? So now when you go back and you look at the roots of where you from, so like all my roots are from here. All his roots are from here. So naturally, the roots that he got and our roots do like this.
Balla, these basketball courts, man, what they mean out here, man?
Everything. Like you said, it's history, man. A lot of stuff happened right here. Like, we had stuff I can't speak on, stuff I can't, that happened right here that made me, like, who I am for real.
Yeah.
When I first met IDK, he came to me and gave me something. I ain't never seen him in my life. He told me something, like, everybody around me can help me, and like I can help them. So, like, basically, if I can get this right here, I want all my men come right here and talk to Ebro. Talk to IDK. Same type of things that I get, I want them to have. He told me that. I used to think like that, but I never seen it like a person like just come to me and just, man, here you go.
Out the mud.
That's all I think about my journey. I ain't trying to do this again.
Malcolm X talked about it. You've heard different leaders talk about how our communities get a brain drain, meaning the most intellectual, the most successful, the most spiritual, the most loving, they leave our neighborhoods.
Oh, yeah.
Because the way our society is set up, and specifically our neighborhoods, you're rewarded for leaving people behind. So what I see you brothers talking about, and it's very important, is making sure that it's cool to show love, not just talk about the love, because, you know, that's common in hip-hop. Everybody talks about where they're from. Uh-huh.
They're going to pass turkeys out on Thanksgiving. They're going to get their little photo ops. Yeah.
Do all of that. But there's another level of commitment that goes beyond just the holiday. It goes into the everyday, the every weekend, and also even the infrastructure that you leave behind. And I think it's important, you know, this album, Simple, what you've been doing and spending your time with, what I hear you talking about, and now we just got to figure out a way to keep that energy going. Yeah. Listen, man, I appreciate y'all for joining us, man, and bringing us out here, man, you know.
No question.
Putting a spotlight on the area where y'all from and then opening up the relationship, too. Yeah, and now we out here.
Yeah, my little brother put me on Apple. That's, you know, that's how I go.
There you go. Balla, it was nice meeting you, bro. Keep
nice
going,
you,
man.
Too.
All right.
For sure.
All right.
Stop.
Check out more of my conversation with IDK. Look for the full interview right now on Apple Music.